Okay, I will explain about the file system structure now. Go to applications, then accessories, and here you will see a terminal tab. Click on that, you will get the terminal. Now do ls space slash. Okay, after opening the terminal, type ls space slash. It will give the root hierarchy of the installation. So as you can see, there are many directories such as bin and mnt proc. So I will explain each of these one by one. So as you can see, there is a directory bin. All the binary files are in this directory. These are executable files. The next one you can see is var. Slash var will be there. All the log files are the variables, that is log files will be stored in this directory. Then there is a directory called home. So if you do ls space slash home, you will see the home directory of the user you have just installed, you have just configured. These are the files by default created in the in your home directory. Again do ls space slash, you will see a directory called is etc. ls, just do ls space slash etc, enter. These are the configuration files of the system installation. We will not go into details of what these files are there for what. Do clear screen using clear command. Again ls space slash, you will see a folder called proc. So do ls space slash proc. These are the files where the system information is stored. For example, do cat space slash proc slash version. If you, then you can see the information about current version of the Linux you have just installed. So there are various files in this proc directory where you can see different system information. There is one more directory called boot. Do ls slash boot. These are the files which are loaded at the boot time. The kernel files are there, so that kernel will be loaded at the boot time. There will be one more directory in the slash, that is called lib. Do ls space slash lib. All the library files will be stored in this directory. Then there is one more directory called tmp in the slash. The temporary files which are created will be stored here, and these get deleted automatically. So if you do ls space slash tmp and enter, you will see these files. One more thing is at the boot time there are some services like networking and all are started. So these services are listed in this file slash etc slash init dot d. Do ls on this directory. and you will see a listing. These are the services started at the boot time. So till now you have created only one user at the time of installation. Suppose you want to create more users. So how do we do that? There is a command called add user. You can use it as follows. As you have logged in using different user than root, you have to use sudo command. Type sudo space add user. Sudo space add user space any username and type enter. It will ask for a password. You enter the password of your current user. Then it will ask for a new Unix password for the user which we are going to create. So enter a password. It will again ask for retyping the same password. Then it will ask for few details such as full name. You can enter the details or keep it blank by pressing enter. At the end it will ask whether the information you have given is correct. Press Y and then enter. Now a new user will be is created in the system. You can check this user by going to ls space slash home slash user your new username. So every time you create a new user, its home directory will be created in the slash home directory. As you have already seen, slash home will contain the previous user and the new user you have just created. You can check it with using this command ls space slash home. Okay, next thing. Now where the passwords are getting stored. So there is a file, you can open it with vim space slash etc space slash passwd. Open this file. Where the passwords are stored, you are creating a user and the password, you are specifying a password. So where these passwords are stored, so there is a file called slash etc slash passwd. You open that file using vim command. So vim space slash etc space passwd. So here you can see the user root in the first line, then the users you have just created at the end. At the end of file, so here I have just created the user Nishant. So at the last line it will say this user, and there is more information such as which is the home directory for Nishant, which is the shell it is using, the bash shell. And as you know, on Linux only hash of the password is stored, and that too is not shown. Thus it is not stored directly in the password file. If you are done with this file, there is one more file called slash etc slash shadow. For getting out of this file, you press shift colon q enter. You have to do sudo space vim space slash etc slash shadow. And here at the end, you will see the new user you have just created, and the hash of this password is stored in the second field. So you will never get a clean text password of any user. Linux always stores the hash of this password. There is one more way in which you can create a new user with using UI. Click on system, go to administration. There you will find at the end users and groups. Click on that. You have to click on unlock and enter the root password. Then press authenticate. So here you will see the users you have just created. There is one more option, like add user. If you want to create a new user, you can press on add user. It will ask for some username. Enter a different username. You can leave the contact information fields blank. Enter a password in the user password field. For the confirmation, you have to re-enter the password and then click on OK. So after clicking OK, you can see the new user getting added to this user listing at the end. So now these are the local users that we have created. There is one more option, like suppose we have to delete the user after we don't want that user to exist anymore. So you can select the user. You don't select the user that you have first created, that is at the time of installation. So select any other user than that. Click on delete. Click on delete. So here this user will be deleted, as you can see from the user listing. And close this window. There is one more way in which you can delete the user with command line option. The command is called del user. On the command line, type del user space. Now type the user you have just created with using add user command. Press enter. You have to use sudo option before del user. So sudo space del user space the username. So it will give the message user is removed. Type ls space home. It will still show the home directory of the users you have just deleted. That is because we haven't used the option of del user to remove the home directories also. So by default it retains the home directories, and all the files in the home directories will be retained. So if you want to delete the home directory also, there is one option that you can see using man command. Type man space del user. there is this option called remove home. To get out of this page, press Q. Now if you use this option, del user space remove home space the username, as I have already deleted this user, I cannot use this option anymore. But if earlier if you had used this option, it would have deleted the home directories also. As I didn't use the remove home option, the home directories are still retained. So now you want to delete the home directories. So how do we do that? The command is called rm. It removes the files. So type rm space minus r space and the directory which you want to delete. That is the home directories slash home, and your username will be your home directory. So give that path here. Press enter. Again you have to use sudo sudo space rm space minus r space the directory path. When you press enter, the directory will be deleted. You can check it using ls space slash home. It will not list the directory which we have just deleted. Minus r is the option used with rm command that will recursively delete the all the directories that might be there in the directory that we are specifying.